Hi folks, this is David Kwan here, and I know I'm late to the party, but this video I want to talk about Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. Such an interesting video game title. But it is a spin-off game in the Metal Gear series, and I do think Metal Gear series had set some interesting spin-offs. You know, Acid, such an interesting series, or two games actually, I don't know if you call that a series. But I have to say, Rising is definitely the craziest, wildest Metal Gear game ever. Maybe you can even consider it to be a Metal Gear game. It definitely tries to feel a lot like Metal Gear game, but then at the same time, it's just like, wow, like this game, what? You know, it's just like, it's pretty clear that this is a Platinum Game Studios game. This is a Platinum game. More than a Kojima game or a Konami game, this is a Platinum game. And it just, you can feel it with this ridiculously frenetic action throughout the entire experience. And also, as you'd expect out of a Platinum Games game, there's a lot of cheesiness here, like really ridiculous cheesiness, especially the game story. But the story part, I think I'm gonna talk about that in a different video. In this video, I actually just want to talk about, I guess, my experience with the gameplay and the game, like how it plays itself. Overall, I have to say, this game is crazy. One of the very first enemies that I get to fight in this game is the Metal Gear Ray. It's a highly agile version. It's super extremely tall robot. It fires like ridiculous amount of missiles at you. I mean, sure, you've faced a bunch of these things, a bunch of Metal Gear Rays and Metal Gear Solid 2 before. But for some reason, in this game, Ray just looks like it's much larger and so much more menacing. And it's crazy because you're supposed to take this thing down using a sword. The whole fight is like just a grand spectacle. I think I try to do a let's play of this game before using my iPad as like a, you know, just capturing footage, whatever, you know, on my TV. And that was kind of going well, except my computer, my MacBook is 4 years old, and the iMovie, it couldn't handle the new iMovie, so it just like was frustrating to try to edit the Let's Play and whatever, try to upload it, so I just gave up on that. But just doing a Let's Play of just fighting this Metal Gear Ray, it's just insane, you know, and there's a real satisfaction that I felt controlling Raiden in this game. And his movements are so freaking fast. You can sprint and he's just everywhere, all around, crazy. But it actually feels so... The controls are very tight, it feels like, at least the movement. And so, Raiden, to me, proves that cyborgs are indeed superhuman. He's insane. At one point during the fight, you know, Ray launches a slew of missiles at Raiden. After you kind of just slash the thing to pieces. Most people, when there are missiles thrown at you, I think most people will try to run away or dodge or shelter themselves. Not Raiden, though. Raiden runs towards it. Runs towards a barrage of missiles. And then he jumps from missile to missile to missile. And then eventually gets close enough to Ray. And then you do that slow motion and just slash like crazy. Which is physically impossible to do 60 slashes in 2 seconds. But anyway, this game just throws out realism out the window. It's just insane. I mean, it's overkill. Like, fucking 80 slashes in 2 seconds for a target is just overkill, but it's a hell of a stress reliever. And the action doesn't end there. That's the beginning of this game. That's the beginning fight of this game. Ray throws Raiden high into the air, and then, you know, Raiden is going down this clock tower building, and there's like lasers and missiles and bullets just throwing at you, and just dodging left and right, and then jump and slash, and then Raiden just cuts the Metal Gear in half. Shit, like, that is insane, and that's like the, you know, that's pretty typical of this game. There are a lot of holy shit moments in this game, and I kind of felt that way too with a Platinum Games game I played before. It was Vanquish. I think that's the only Platinum Games game I played before. I know there's Bayonetta and there's Mad World, Bayonetta 2 just recently came out in Japan, so. Platinum Games, they're known for this kind of really ridiculously crazy action stuff. And Vanquish, I'm trying to remember, had a lot of those crazy set-piece moments too, like that part where you're on top of this moving rail cart in the air, and then you are inside a space station planet, but then there, I don't know, Vanquish did some amazingly ridiculous things, but In my mind, you know, I'm comparing the moments that I had with Rising and the moments that I had with Vanquish. And Rising, the concepts are, the premise is like fairly, you know, fairly typical. Oh, you're gonna fight against Metal Gear Ray. Oh, you're gonna go against this helicopter. Oh, you know, you're on top of a train fighting Jetstream Sam. Like, the premise is very simple. But the feeling that I get of actually playing, like, they're the most memorable moments I've ever had. Like, and just I don't know, it's just insane. So, I can really say that, except for the very last boss, if you guys played Rising, the last boss is... But except for that boss, the boss fights in this game are quite amazing. You know, gameplay-wise, there were some minor annoying aspects of some bosses, especially Monsoon. But honestly, you know, I was too busy trying to take everything in and button-mashing, properly to be bothered by those minor annoyances. Now, what I mean by button-mashing properly, this game doesn't really play like a button-masher, and so it kind of took me a while to get used to that. So the first time I think the most amount of time I spent against a boss is like the second boss, the wolf boss, the LQ84I robotic wolf thing, Blade Wolf, I guess that's what you call it. But that thing, I spent so much time because I had game over after game over after game over. I think that's just because I was trying to get used to the controls. There is no dodge button in Rising. I think, you know, people, if you read anything about Rising, there's no dodging, there's no blocking, it's just all action, like you're just slashing and slashing. So the only thing you could do is parry, and timing your parry is important. But like in typical games like God of War or Devil May Cry or something, like, you know, you do your combos, you know, square, triangle, and you just do your combo and you expect it to come out. But in this game, I have to, so let me get my controller. This game, I had to make sure that I was pressing each button and seeing that action happen. So if I hit square, I see right and slash, and so that's when I hit square and I just stop. And I see him do slash, and then I hit square again, and then I see him do slash, and then I do triangle, and I see him do a heavy kind of whirl. You know, I have to, like, time my presses properly, because to parry, I have to press square and the direction of the attack to parry. So that has to happen when the enemy attacks me with the weak attack. So that took me a while to get used to. But, like, it feels nice once I finally got the hang of it. And the enemy, Raiden's attack animations are just... There's so many of them, and he uses his, you know, legs to grab a sword, just like he does in Metal Gear Solid 4 cutscene. Just all of that is just—it's really kind of amazing to watch and play at the same time. I just really enjoyed the high octane ridiculousness of Metal Gear Rising. Although that's not to say the gameplay is perfect. You know, there are some things really, really annoying about the way this combat system works. Because some of the enemies in this game have moves, have attacks that are immune to parrying. And that's when the enemy, like, he's attacking and he glows yellow or he glows gold. That's when you know you can't parry that shit. You gotta get out of there. But like I mentioned, there is no dodge button or dodge move in this game. So you have to dodge that attack, that yellow attack. To dodge that, like, there is no quick way to dodge it. You have to, like, you know, drag your analog stick on the opposite direction, but Raiden is moving so fast that you have to counteract this momentum to move away from that, and that takes a little bit of a delay, but by that time you might get hit. Jumping doesn't work as a dodge, so those attacks are really annoying because there's no way for Raiden to dodge. The most annoying enemies in this game that I thought was this gorilla cyborg enemy. These are just weird, I don't know, but they look like gorillas. I don't know what you call them, but they have attacks that are unparryable, you know, like some of those big hammer dudes, but that's not the problem. It's the fact that their unparryable attack is a charge. They run at you for like 3 seconds, and you have to be running around for like 3 seconds. The problem is the camera control. You know, the camera, like, automatically starts moving away from the enemy, so you can't even see if the enemy is following or not, so you stop, but then these gorilla enemies have a tendency to jump up in the air, out of sight, and will land on top of you and will hurt you. Just so annoying the way this is designed. I really, really fucking hate these guys. So there are those enemies, and it's just a constant struggle against cameras. You know, how you control your camera, running away from the enemy and trying to dodge them when they can't parry. And when they grab you, it's so annoying. You have to, like, do this thingy, you know, go back and forth with the controller. Just hate those gorilla enemies. The worst section in this game involves those gorilla enemies, in my part. That's the part where Raiden enters these dark underground tunnels. That section, like, I think it's tried to be kind of unique and slow down the pace of the game. Everything is dark, so you have to use Raiden's, like, enhanced vision or detective mode to be able to see. But the problem is, when Raiden, if you start running, or if you do any kind of action move, the enhanced vision mode starts fading away and it's gone. So when a gorilla attacks you and you attack back, you can attack it for like 5 seconds, but then your vision mode goes totally dark. So now you have to, like, it was an interesting design kind of idea, but to do this, to have this section was really annoying. Of course, you can try to sneak past them using a cardboard box and stealth method, but that's really tedious when you're in a dark area. If you go into a cardboard box, your enhanced vision mode goes off, so it's completely dark. So that's probably, in my opinion, the worst part of the game, other than the last boss fight. And the last boss fight is... another part of the gameplay that's kind of really annoying, I have to say, are the gadgets and the items. There's really... Like, it's kind of cumbersome to use items and gadgets. And by items, I'm also including Stinger missile launchers or RPGs. Those count as items, in my opinion, or grenades, whatever. Those are hard, because, you know, you have to go into the option menu. There's like a half-second delay to go into the action menu, or the item menu. So you might get hurt trying to get into the menu to equip the right items. But then to use grenades, you have to stand still. Again, this is a game about fast-paced action where every shit is going crazy all around you, and it's just ridiculous action. So everything else is crazy around you, but to use a grenade, Raiden has to stop, stand still, and throw a grenade. He'll get hurt in the process. It's just very inconvenient. And also, when you start using RPG, also Raiden stands still, and you can change the sensitivity level all the way up high. But, you know, trying to aim with the rocket launcher is just like, really, it really slows down the pace of the game. I really wish they could have integrated, you know, the fast action swordplay with actual grenade throwing and aiming play a little better, because it's really disjarring when you're trying to do either or. So most of the time, I didn't bother with items or gadgets, only when I had to. And there are times when you have to, when you have those annoying flying enemies. Any enemies that fly in these games, I just grrr. So that's all I have to say. The last boss fight is just, I don't know. I don't think I really have to talk too much about it. Maybe it's a topic for a different video. When I got to play this game, the downloadable content, you know, the Blade Wolf and the Just Stream Sam, those were free. I don't know if they're still free now, but I got to download them free. I thought that was pretty awesome, and I actually really enjoyed them. Although I guess I might talk about them in a different video, just because there are some interesting. It's kind of a repeat of the game. You get to kind of replay the game with a different character. There's a little bit of story cutscenes, although what's added in the cutscenes, I have to say I'm a little disappointed, but maybe I'll talk about it in a different video. But definitely expect another video on Metal Gear Rising where I talk about the game's story, because that's a whole other topic in itself that I really want to talk about with spoilers. All of it, you know. I just want to talk about Metal Gear Rising story. Not necessarily because I think it impacts the actual canon Metal Gear series story, but just because Metal Gear Rising story is just batshit insane for what it is. So I'll leave it at that. It's a pretty fun, exciting game. Gameplay wise, there are some little minor annoyances there, but this is a platinum game. Platinum game is super exciting, super action oriented. They do action games the way they do, and that's still the case with Metal Gear Rising. So that's my two cents. I hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.